Made with EasyVid, freeware at EasyVid.com. The top 11 laptops for counting down. Go to EasyVid.com/top11laptops. Number 11 is the Asus N56VJ-DH71 15.6-inch laptop. Now, this one is on the premium side of our list. It weighs in at almost $1,000 right now. And it's got Windows 8, and it's got 8 gigs of RAM, a terabyte hard drive. It's, for most intents and purposes, you would not need anything more powerful than this. And if you want to spring for something really high-end, you could think about this one. It's got quite good sound, and these Asus models are kind of known for being good keyboards. Like, they'll have a real non-chiclet, like, real good-feeling keyboard. It'll sound great. There's some solidity, and, you know, someone says it feels like a $1,500-plus machine. So, if you got the bucks and you want something that's, like, you know, going to be really, really great, you can go for this. Now, like any of these laptops, there can be problems. And I'm not going to tell you that one of these is going to literally last better than the other, because you never know. All right, let's take a look at our list. Number 10 is the Acer Aspire V3-571G-6407 15-inch laptop. About the right same size, but about half the price. And there's some reasons. One, it's got less RAM. It's got 4 gigs of RAM. Watching YouTube or whatever, it should be fine. 500 gigs of hard drive space is also fine. But the screen size is something you want to think about carefully. This has a 1366 by 768 pixel screen display. And that is significantly smaller in resolution. So you just can't fit as much on screen, which means, like, when you're doing complicated stuff, you don't have as much real estate to work with. And that's why this thing is under $600. So the screen is, a lot of people overlook that, but you really want to look at the resolution of it. A lot of people are saying that on computers like this, they'll uninstall a lot of the software that comes with it. I would agree that's often a really good idea. Another thing you'll see as a difference with a computer like this around this price point is the keyboard and the trackpad. Does the keyboard and the trackpad feel solid under your fingers? And that's what's, like, quite important for a lot of people. Some people will just go ahead and turn off the trackpad and use an external mouse. So, you know, people, especially on this model, they're talking about how the trackpad is difficult, oversensitive, not sensitive enough. All right, easyvid.com/top11laptops. Number 9 is the HP Envy DV6-7218NR 15.6-inch laptop. Coming in now a bit under $500, this is a Windows 8 laptop. It's a 1366 by 768 screen. So again, this is a lower resolution screen, and that's why it's cheaper. It's got 4 gigs of RAM. And this is another entry-level contender. And, you know, HP is quite well known for its laptops. And you probably can't go too wrong with this one. It's got a DVD drive, DVD burner. Now, as far as the comments go, people talk about it having Beats audio, which I would say means basically nothing. Maybe it's a little bit louder. But you should keep in mind with HP laptops that if you have a problem and you try to call HP, you will get somebody who barely speaks English, and that really can be a real bummer. All right, next up is the Dell Inspiron i15R1632SLV laptop, which is number 8 on our list. Also, almost exactly the same price as the HP. Let's try to compare it a bit. It's got a bit more RAM, 6 gigs of RAM. It's got a slightly bigger hard drive, 750 gigabyte hard drive, also 15-inch screen. So one important difference here is it's a Windows 7 machine, which could for some people be a lot better if you find Windows 8 to be annoying, the start screen, if you're confused by Windows 8. Windows 7 is now a really mature product, and it's guaranteed to work with pretty much anything. So let's see what some of the reviews are like here. This one has a chiclet keyboard, which is not ideal. Because it's just not as nice a surface to work with as a regular style keyboard. It comes with some silly snap-on colorful covers, if that's something that's of interest to you. To me, that would not really sway me one way or the other. In my experience, Dell has a bit better customer support. But, you know, when you're buying something as complicated as one of these laptops, if you have a problem, you can get into really nasty situations where all you can do is send it back and hope for the best. All right, number 7 on our list is Asus VivoBook S400CADH51T14-inch Ultrabook. So this is different from the last two we were looking at. It's an Ultrabook, which is a marketing scheme come up with Intel to sell basically laptops that are sleek looking and look a bit like the MacBook Pro, to be honest. So you're going to pay more for this. It's about $700 now on Amazon. It actually has kind of less features than the last two systems we were looking at. It's got a smart hard drive, and it's 4 gigs of RAM, but it is Windows 8. And it's going to be a lot smaller and lighter. It's only 4 pounds. And although it has the same screen resolution, it's kind of sleeker, smaller, more portable, and you pay a premium for that. This one, we should say, has a touch screen. And Microsoft is really pushing the touch screen elements in Windows 8. So if you want to be really with the program, this one could be cool. Are you really going to use a touch screen that much? I don't know. I mean, Windows software has kind of yet to catch up to a large extent with Windows 8. Again, with most laptops in this price range, it has a chiclet keyboard. It's not going to feel as solid as a more expensive or bigger laptop, but that might be okay. It's also going to have maybe not as loud sound. I mean, that's one issue with getting a laptop this small, is often the speakers cannot keep up. So you have the usual complaints about the pre-installed software. You can, it's called bloatware. You can get rid of that. And this one, keep in mind, there is no internal DVD drive. So if you have games or other software you want to install from DVD, you're going to be a bit out of luck. Also, with the Asus, people complain about the trackpads. This one has some complaints, so keep that in mind. All right, next up is the Toshiba Satellite C855DS5340 15.6-inch laptop. This one is quite inexpensive. It's in the U.S. right now, it's $350. So let's take a look at this and try to figure out why it's less expensive than the other ones we've looked at. It's also a 1366 by 768 laptop. It runs Windows 8. It is not a touchscreen. It has 320 gigabyte hard drive, which is a bit smaller than the others we've looked at, and 4 gigs of RAM, which should be fine unless you're doing a lot of really a lot of heavy duty media collecting. So one thing is that the keyboard is not so great. Again, the keyboard is what often suffers on these lower end laptops. Also, keep in mind that Toshiba used to have a really strong reputation for laptops, but you're getting something at this level, this at $350 or so, you're going to have the same problems you have with cheap laptops from any provider. All right, let's look at number 6 on our list, Toshiba Satellite C885. This is a little bit more expensive, and you see what you get more for maybe 70, 80 bucks more. You get 6 gigs of RAM, a 500 gigabyte hard drive. Now, also Windows 8, what is the difference here between 4 and 6 gigs of RAM? If you're just going to be using YouTube and so forth and cruising the web, it's really not going to make much difference. Where it's going to make difference is if you're running a lot of programs at the same time and if they're intensive. For example, let's say you're running a game and you have Microsoft Word open and you're running EasyVid and so forth. All right, let's look at number 4 on our list, the Asus F55A. AH91 15.6-inch laptop. This one is about $400 in the United States right now. So this is going to be a lower-end Asus. It's not an Ultrabook, not quite as sleek-looking. It has 4 gigs of RAM and a 320-gigabyte hard drive. So this is a lower-end Asus running Windows 8. And it's a bit heavier than the other Asus we looked at. This is 5.8 pounds. So it's going to be more of a luggable than a really sleek notebook, but if you're not moving it that much, it may not matter. The reviews on this are pretty good. People say the keyboard feels quite nice. The picture on the screen looks good. So the quality of the keyboard is something that you'll get, and a quality of touchpad on a larger laptop. Now, also with a larger laptop, often you have a lower battery life. So there's some trade-offs to keep in mind here. All right, let's go to easyvid.com/top11laptops. And number 3 is the Asus, another Asus, the Asus VivoBook X202E. This is about $500. Now, this is a number 3 laptop that's for sale on Amazon right now. And this is what's a bit confusing, is that it's nearly indistinguishable from, say, the number 8 laptop that's for sale. And that's because the model numbers on these laptops are really, really confusing, and they come out with a zillion different elements. So you got to look at the features and kind of ignore the model numbers. For this one, what's different about it is it's got a touchscreen and it's Windows 8. So if you want a cheaper accessibility to the touchscreen feature, this Asus might be good for you. Now, this one has a screen resolution of 1366 by 768, which is okay, and it falls under the category of a really tiny laptop. It's 11 inches, 2.9 pounds, so very portable. For some people, this will be frustrating to use. I know in my experience, trying to use a laptop this small can really be a nightmare sometimes. Okay, let's go to easyvid.com. Top 11 laptops. Number 2 is a Dell Inspiron 15-inch i15N1900BK15-inch laptop. Now, this one is pretty inexpensive. It's coming in around $300 right now, so it's really cheap. 4 gigs of RAM, 500 gigabyte hard drive, Windows 7. At this price, you probably cannot go wrong with this Dell and why it's selling so well right now. DVD-ROM drive. What you're going to sacrifice with a laptop like this is power and speed. Gaming, something like this, is probably underpowered. All right, let's look at the number one of the top 11 laptops. Go to easyvid.com/top11laptops. We've got the Dell Inspiron i15R1633SLV15.6-inch laptop. Now, this is the number one selling laptop on Amazon.com right now. Why is that? It's under $600, 750 gigabyte hard drive, 6 gigabytes of RAM. Now notice it's a Windows 7 laptop. I think there are a lot of people out there who are not ready to jump into Windows 8 and would rather have something powerful that they know will work with everything, with all the software that they have. So it's interesting that people, this happened also with Windows XP, that Windows Vista, that people wanted to stick with Windows XP for quite a while. Dell has had really strong reviews, so it seems to be the number one because such strong feedback about it. All right, so thanks for watching. Check out the whole list. Go to easyvid.com/top11laptops.